It wasn't professional for him to not only not make the weight, but then once he was over, not even trying to make the weight. And I couldn't focus on, you know, everything that, you know, the fine that he is supposed to pay and all that kind of stuff. I'm going to address that stuff now that the fight is over, but that's not right. You know, it's a championship fight. You're supposed to conduct yourself like a champion, come in on weight, and if you are overweight, make the effort to make the weight. So I probably fought a guy that was 190 pounds.
Trevor,
you've
lost a fight since you were 12 years old. How much pressure is on you when you get into the ring at this stage?
Man, it's always a lot of pressure. It comes with the territory. I mean, I don't think the winning streak is what brings the pressure. You just learn how to deal with it, you know? You learn how to deal with it. But I think just the fact that I just love to win. I'm telling you, when we're sitting up there at the press conference and people are talking about the winning streak and you're one of the best in the world, we honestly don't talk about that stuff in my camp. We don't. We don't discuss it. We don't talk about it. We just keep grinding. We stay focused. And we know we got to keep pushing. And it almost kind of irritates me when I hear people keep talking about it, like the heat of the fight. I know you guys are just doing your job, but it's not something we talk about. So we're just in grind mode all the time. And when you got that kind of mindset, you look back and say, man, we've accomplished a lot, but we're not focused on that because, like I keep telling you, one loss in this business changes everything. And you can't afford to have a bad night in this business.
Did you feel rusty during the first round?
I mean, I didn't feel rusty. It just takes time to get acclimated. It takes time to get a rhythm, you know?
With your healthy shoulder.
Who do you want next if you could have any fight?
I want the biggest fight out there. Whatever fight that is. You know, the networks and the fans and the media, they got ways of building guys, and building monsters, and building guys that are invincible. And whoever that guy is, that's the guy.
Leave it at that fight at 175?
Why do you want me to keep going 175?
No, because people are waiting for you to go 175 for you to lose. People are waiting for you to go to 275 for you to win.
I'm not a light heavyweight right now. I'm a 168-pound fighter.
Andre, he thinks on the win. And he might skip light heavyweight and just go right to heavyweight.
Well, he said he wanted to end his career at heavyweight.
Yeah.
Okay, let me ask you a good question. Could you retire today and run for mayor of Oakland?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell you this. I don't know how much longer I got in this sport. I'm not talking next week retiring, but you know, Dan might not want to hear that. But
I'll be your campaign manager.
Yeah.
I'm not going to be the 40-year-old boxer, I promise.
Yeah.
I know you guys have heard it before, but I got 20 years in this sport. 20 years in the sport. And giving max effort, giving it everything that I have, and even though I missed the sport this last 14 months, I enjoyed my time off. I enjoyed being home. I enjoyed the broadcasting and doing what I had to do. So I don't know how much longer I got in this sport. We're going to try to, you know, go out with a bang, and I feel like we got a few more years left in this. But I don't know how much longer I got.
Let's do much like Andre. Are there any areas of opportunity?
Say it again?
Are there any areas of opportunity?
In terms of
improvement.
Oh yeah. I still don't feel like I've arrived yet, like just overall. I put on some good performances, I think, and beating some good guys, but like I can look at the Fox fight and say, man, that wasn't my best. I can look at tonight and say, man, we won, but that wasn't my best. Dawson was close. That's a fight where we pretty much did everything we wanted to do, break him down mentally, physically, and then stop him and get him out of there. There's a few fights I can point to and say, man, we executed everything. But as a whole, I don't think that I'm quite there yet.
I sat next to Kareem Mayfield while we watched the fight. Dan, we both agreed that you were going for the kill in the 12th round. Was that correct?
Yeah, I just wanted to be smart and look at my opportunity because I'm telling you, those kind of guys are hard to fight because they don't try to win rounds. He's not coming in trying to compete minute for minute trying to win a round. He's trying to get lucky. So he's conserving his energy. He's taking punishment. And then the 12th round, his corner pumps him up. Go get him. And he's coming, winging. And so you got to be smart in the 12th round. You know, you see Floyd when he fought Canelo. He pretty much moved the whole 12 rounds.
You got to get him
out. He dominated 1 through 11 and then took the 12th round off. And some people don't like that, but he moves on to the next.
Andre, what are your thoughts on where you rank in the pound-for-pound list, and would you like to overtake Floyd one day?
I mean, from a competitive standpoint, I would love to have a number one spot, but Floyd Mayweather is the number one guy in boxing right now. He has done this and been successful and competed at the highest level since I've been a kid. Since I've been an amateur fighter, he's been doing this. I'm not the number one fighter in the world. Floyd Mayweather's the number one fighter in the world. So unless he retires or something happens and maybe he gets beat, then maybe I'll take that spot. But I'm content being number two right now. I respect the guys who, I pay homage to the guys who have gone before me. Floyd Mayweather has helped mold my style. Floyd Mayweather, I'm watching Floyd Mayweather fights all day today leading up into this fight. These guys have helped me get to where I'm at in more ways than they realize. So I pay homage to these guys, and I respect these guys. So he deserves that top spot.
As a boxing fan that you are, not a boxing superstar, what's it like to have Mike Tyson and Sugar Ray Leonard sitting right under the apron?
Oh, Mike was here?
Yeah.
20 years in the game, what fuels you as a fighter?
Let me answer this question. So Mike was here, Sugar Ray was here, and Chris Byrne. I just met Chris Byrne.
And Roy Jones.
And, you know, of course, RJ. That's my childhood hero right there.
And Rob Schneider.
And Rob Snyder. It was a good night.
What are some of the things that are fueling you as a fighter after 20 years in the game? Like, what still makes you want to come to the ring every time you have a fight?
Well, I know I'm not at my best. I know I'm still not at my best. I'm still not at my prime. I'm approaching my prime. I'm not in my prime. I feel like it's going to be a zone that I get into the busier that I get. Burgess told me this for years. He said, when you start getting three fights a year, Can you start consistently fighting, so you don't start doing stuff that shocks you. So once we start getting busier and start getting in the zone, that's when we're going to see some things that I think we haven't seen before.
How soon would you like to return to the ring?
One more question, okay, you guys, and then you guys can come up here and get a few more.
I ain't got a pink blazer on. Dan Goosey.
Andre.
Hollywood Dan Goosey.
Carnation pink.
My wife got it for me.
I just didn't like it. I just acknowledged it.
Pink underwear, too.
Hey, Dan, we call that salmon.
How soon would you like to return to the ring, Andre? How soon do you want to get back in there?
How do you feel physically?
He was winging some big shots, but a lot of times with guys like that, those aren't the guys that really hit hard, they throw hard. They don't really, to answer your question though, he didn't hurt me or anything. I got a few bumps and bruises on my head and stuff like that, that's why I got the ice pack. Just from fouls, man, just rabbit punches. I tried to keep my hand up to protect myself and you know, when I could, I tried to get mine back too.
When are you going to go back to the Shark Tank fight?
Hey, Andre.
What? That was a question for me.
Wait, ask him that question. That's a great question.
It's close to his house.
What did they ask?
He said Shark Tank.
Shark Tank. Oh, Shark Tank. Well, we would have been there tonight if they didn't have a damn concert. You know, I mean, that was the crazy thing about it. Getting out here to Ontario was really the last building standing. We looked to go to MGM. They had UFC tonight, so we couldn't book that. We went to MSG. They wanted Andre badly there. They had the Knicks going tonight. We went to Staples, booked. We went to Oracle, Warriors playing tonight.
Champ.
So there were really no arenas that were available. So this was really the last building standing on either side of the coast.
Hey, Andre.
So we did try to get to the Shark Tank this fight.
Congrats on the victory. Can you talk about your preparation and the documentary you've been working on over 14 months?
Yeah. We're working with HBO right now, trying to see if they want to pick up the documentary. My good friend Squint, his real name is Christopher. Put his government out there. Him and his team, they did a great job just documenting everything from my injury from day one. They got a lot of vulnerable moments, and just I didn't want to just disappear for the time that I was off. I wanted to capture everything, and you know, we're trying to talk to HBO now to see if they can pick it up so you guys can get a glimpse of what I went through to get back. But as far as training camp and, you know, my strength and conditioning coach, and my other strength and conditioning.